The first excerpt that you have is Dance of the Tumblers. And this right here is to demonstrate your articulation and how staccato can you make these eighth notes while still making it very exciting and sort of joyful sounding, I suppose. So the tempo is about 120. My cell phone metronome, that's about this fast. And I'll play through it first at about that tempo to kind of give you an idea of what it should sound like. And that's it. So you have basically two contrasting sections in this short excerpt. One is fortissimo, and so coming out a little bit closer towards the tip of the reed will allow you to play with more volume while still being able to control the articulations. And you still want to make sure that each of those staccato notes still has a little bit of roundness, so I'm not stopping the notes with my tongue, so it doesn't sound too Morse code-like, like this. I want to make sure that I can still let those staccato notes resonate just a little bit. That way it's not too short. And then when I do finally get to measure 116, the letter before, or so the measure before letter O, I can lay into that accent just a little bit more and allow that to pop out of the texture. Two very different articulation styles there, and I want to make sure that I'm making a clear difference between both. What does the staccato sound like, and then what does the accented G sound like? The second half, after letter O, the dynamic changes, so it's a much softer mezzo forte, and I have a combination of staccato eighth notes and then regularly articulated quarters. So I want to make sure that I'm capturing the two different articulation styles for those notes. That's over-exaggerated just a little bit. If I were to go back and play it at about the right tempo. What I want to avoid doing is making sure that I'm really accenting those quarter notes. Or making them too short as if they are staccato. So I got to make sure I'm finding the balance between those two things. Okay? So that's Dance of the Tumblers. Then